Hey, my name is Habib Ahmed, and you are listening to the Buckword Podcast. Each episode, I talk to different guests from all over the world of Pakistani background or some type of connection to Pakistan. For this episode, I wanted to catch up with our community on Discord and ask them how they're doing. As you might have heard from previous episodes, we run a Discord server, which is basically a modern online chat room service that allows both text and voice chats. I wanted to ask our community how they're faring with this pandemic crisis and the lockdowns that are going on in the majority of countries at the moment. I spoke to several people at different times, from UK, Canada, Dubai, Pakistan, and combined their thoughts to create this episode, along with my own thoughts, of course. I asked them questions about their work and school and sleep schedules, how their communities are responding, and what they're doing to pass the time. Just a quick note, this is one of our light episodes, not to be taken seriously, and just supposed to be an easy listen. There's already enough stress as it is in the world regarding this pandemic, and I wanted to shine a light on how we can actually continue living and readapt rather than follow the anxiety-provoking nature of TV news. Maybe you'll get some ideas from some of the thoughts shared by our guests. Maybe you'll get a few laughs. And the purpose of this listen is not much more than that. So let's go ahead and talk to our guests. A few of our guests were talking about adapting to this new normal of working from home or taking online classes. Everything is becoming virtual, and separating work life from home life for us can be a challenge sometimes due to that. And of course, managing our daily routines can be a challenge as well. Here's a few people talking about their routines and challenges during my conversation with Hamza from Canada, Arfa from UK, and Aman from Islamabad, Pakistan.
Before this, I used to wake up around 6:30 a.m. to get to work for 9, and then I'd get home around 7:30 p.m. because I live kind of far from work, right? I live like an hour each way. Nowadays, I wake up at 8:55 for 9 o'clock work, and at 5, it's literally just immediately after work ends, I switch tabs and I'm redditing, or I switch tabs and I'm playing games with friends. So honestly, It sounds kind of like, actually sounds extremely privileged to say this, and most people can't do this, but at least for me, like, I feel like I'm saving more money and I have more free time while The quarantine is in effect. And it's that way for like, I think most of my family, Extended family is like this, because you have like engineers, you have developers, you can do your job from home, right? You're not too affected by this. So depending on your occupation and depending on where you live, obviously, it can feel freeing in a way. That's what I was talking about. Yeah. That's what I was talking earlier about, how I hope this changes workplace culture, because we haven't gotten any less efficient working from home as developers. So just from that perspective, A lot of occupations, it can save people's time. It can save their money from like parking or commuting. It can save the environment by not having as many cars on the road if we just change our culture to be like this.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah.
Let me share my routine with you guys as well. Very similar to Hamza's. So I would wake up 6 in the morning, and my wife would drop me off to the train station. And then I'd take the train downtown Boston. That's about a 20-25 minute train ride. So I'd get to office, work, come back. You know, again, she'd pick me up from the train station. It was quite a trek, you know, it was a bit of a hassle. And Fridays I would work from home. So one day a week I was allowed to work from home. So that was always nice. And I've never worked from home this long. In fact, I always prefer going to the office because I feel like I've done something for the day, you know, and I've been out, I've done my time outside for the day, and I can come home and relax. So now the lines are kind of blurred, where I can't even tell the weekdays apart from the weekends because I know I'm going to be home all the time anyway. So now I just wake up, I sleep in a little bit. So I sleep until like 7:30 because I don't have to commute to work, right?
Yeah.
So I wake up, I turn my laptop. Sometimes I turn it on in bed. I start checking my email from bed. And then I take some meetings and stuff. But one thing I've learned is this is the first time I've worked from home for so long. It's been about 2 months now. And probably another month to go, at least one more month of working from home, maybe two more. But it's surprisingly not that inefficient. I feel like some days I'm working more because my boss is pretty cool about it. He's like, you know, we know you're not going to be able to do 9 to 5. So we know you're going to be taking breaks in between and going for walks and all that stuff, right? Our hours are no longer 9 to 5 or 8 to 5 or whatever. Our hours are more like we are available any time of the day because we are home, right? So sometimes at 2 o'clock, I'll go out, take a walk or something, or we'll go for a drive, and then I'll come back online and work. Sometimes I'll just say I'm logging off for the day at like 1, and then I'll log back in at night and then get my work done that way. So it works out pretty well, actually. At the same time, it's like kind of like I'm working all the time. So I don't like that aspect of it. Like the lines are kind of blurred, right? So there's no set hours for working. So that's kind of a drawback. But honestly, I don't mind not commuting. I find it much more relaxing, a much easier way to get work done.
I'm glad your employer is that nice.
Sometimes I'll log in, I'll take a meeting and things like that, or a few meetings, and then I'll go take a shower.
Same.
Yeah.
One thing I don't like is that like my parents can come in while I'm in the middle of a meeting, and I'm like, I'm in the middle of something, come back later.
Oh my God, same. Yes.
I think the thing I struggled with the most when it came to online classes was creating that environment at home to study in. Because you'd have my little brother or sister just coming in yelling, and then everybody, all 50 students, just hearing my younger siblings just yell.
Oh,
so
agreed.
Creating that environment at home is pretty difficult.
I think I said this in a chat once. My dad interrupted a meeting to give me a samosa, and it was like, it's funny because we don't usually even have samosa, but, and I work in a very predominantly white company as well. It's called the National Trust. You can't really get any more British than that. And the first thing they hear me in the first online meeting we have is, Arva, someone's here. And I'm like, just because you're whispering doesn't mean they can't hear you.
Doesn't mean they can't hear you. Yeah, right. Was it a video meeting?
Yeah, it was. Yeah. And they just saw me like turn off the camera and just, it was so funny. There's been so many times where I'm like eating and I think my video is off and it's not, and I'm muted and they can just see me eating pilau. Someone like messages me halfway through saying, turn your video off. And I'm like, oh no.
That's why I never turn my video on. Most of my team usually has theirs on. Mm-hmm. I just keep it off unless someone specifically asks. And I'm like, all right.
Yeah, exactly.
I have a lot of one-on-ones, so I have to have like the video on because we're doing stuff that you have to like talk face-to-face.
Got it.
Just going back to what you were saying about the lines being blurred, is there anything you found yourself doing to try and separate work from home life? Because I tried to set up my office in my brother's old room. Fortunately, he came back home. But unfortunately, I lost my office. So now I'm working in my bedroom and it's so hard to wake up.
Yeah, I was going to say the very first thing was I have a separate office. So that helps a lot. And like I said, I turn on my laptop sometimes in bed, but I don't usually stay in bed for more than 20 minutes. Like I actually go and I like being proper. And I feel like after I take my very first meeting, which is usually at 8 o'clock in the morning, I go straight for a shower and I dress up. And my wife makes fun of me. She's like, why do you dress up? Like why don't you get back in your PJs? And I'm like, I don't like, I like acting like I am at work. So I literally wear like a shirt tucked into my pants and maybe not as formal as I would be at actual work. You know, at the actual office, but close enough. Like I'll wear something that seems more proper. And I've heard psychologically that can help a lot in terms of productivity.
Yeah, same.
So that does help me.
I always get dressed. At least the top half is like business and the bottom half is usually casual, like joggers or something. But
Do you have productivity issues?
I have more what Hamza was saying about like, I will get my work done and in between meetings, I'll find myself like on Reddit or I don't know. I'll just find myself reaching for my phone way more before I would like chuck my phone in my bag and just forget about it kind of thing while I'm at work. Now I like reach to it like all the time talking to people. Or...
You're saying that I'm playing Halo in between meetings. seriously. Or I'll watch YouTube videos. So I try not to run away from that. Like I just try to be real. Like, you know, you're at home. I feel like most people are unproductive. Or less productive at home anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For me, that's the case.
But at the end of the day, I take deadlines very seriously. Like if I have a deadline in mind, like I got to get something done by the end of the day or by the end of the week, I get it done even if it means playing games right now and then logging in 3 hours later and then just mashing it out.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Mm-hmm. I'm just struggling because there's less to do and I like having things to do.
When it comes to unproductivity, it's just more of when it comes to assignments and things that are due, that's not an issue because I know I can just do that at my own pace. Back to the point that you were saying that you have to get changed and whatnot, I think that very heavily affects me because I find myself that when I'm not dressed up for like, you know, what I would normally wear for university and whatnot, I get so lethargic and lazy just sitting there. And I find myself that 90% of the time I'm falling asleep mid-class, which is something I would never do in uni. But this whole, you know, dressing up appropriately and whatnot, I really should start doing that, actually, now that you've mentioned it. But I found that just waking up in my shorts and shirt, that's not enough to keep me up during classes or keep me productive.
Yeah,
definitely. And if anyone's really struggling with waking up, I think I said it on the group before, but try drinking a glass of water as soon as you wake up. You should have two glasses of water as soon as you wake up to just re-energize your organs. But it really helps. Like, drinking that glass of water helps you just get up. Try. I'm just being a mom now.
No, it's good. It's good. Meanwhile, in a separate chat on a separate day, we were having more fazool slash useless conversations. During one chat, we spoke about how the suffering across the world from toilet paper shortages could be alleviated by teaching people the wonders of the lota. That's right.
You should see all the Muslims in UK are so proud right now because they're like, yeah, we've been using a lota, we do wudu. You guys are just, you know.
Did you know all the bidets have been sold out online? Because Americans are finally waking up to, oh, we don't have to use toilet paper anymore. Because toilet paper is starting to come again. And now Americans are finally starting to learn about different ways to clean your butt.
All the memes are coming out that Corona is making everything Sharia. Because all the clubs are shut down, all the gyms are shut down, everything.
Yeah. I mean, I don't think lota will work really well in the West because people don't want to touch their, you know, poop. So... No. That's the thing. Like, if you're not grown up with that, like, agar aapko choti umar pe nahi sikhaya jata na, then it's not normal. So bidets will work much better here.
Yaar, YouTube tutorials bana denge yaar, koi chalega. YouTube
tutorial nahi, log haath nahi lagana chahte.
Koi nahi, gloves pehen lena yaar, ki hai.
My housemates I lived with at university, my housemates started using a lota, so I had some hope for white people.
Oh, really?
But you know, yeah.
Oh my god, iska mere paas solution lekin hai ye.
तुम्हारे पास क्या है तुम लोटे के आधा हाथ भी लगा दोगे अंदर
यस
बट देयर इज सम क्विक देयर $30 bidets यू कैन बाय देम फ्रॉम Amazon एंड यू इंस्टॉल देम योरसेल्फ इन योर टॉयलेट एंड देन इट जस्ट शूट्स स्ट्रेट अप इनटू योर यू नो अप योर इनटू योर बट विद हाई प्रेशर
इमेजिन करो पानी गर्म आता हो तो क्या करोगे जैसे हम यहां पे होते हैं गर्मियों में ओए होए होए जो जलन होती है ना भाई बस मैं कुछ नहीं कह रहा मैं चुप हो खत्म
Yeah, they can go bidet anyway. The jo bidets hai na, they have so much pressure. Okay, wo bande ne bidet ko test kiya na without sitting on it, and it shot up at the ceiling. So it had that much pressure. So it does. I'm sure it cleans.
Oh my gosh! No thanks.
I do want to try it. I've never tried a bidet.
तो कार में तुमने लोटा रखा हुआ है अभी तक किसके इंतजार कर रहे हो ले आओ एक
लोटा रखा हुआ यार आई मीन नहीं है ना मैंने देखा ऑन इंटरनेट पे मैंने सर्च की वो सारे सोल्ड आउट है क्योंकि अमेरिकन्स आर फाइनली
और यार तो तुम पाकिस्तान से के ले आते कभी किसी लाहौर में कहते भाई 5-6 लोटे बना के डिजाइन वाले भेज दो
yeah.
वो जैसे ट्रक पे नहीं बने होते पाकिस्तान में 8 बनी होती वैसे तुम लोटे पे बनवा के भेजो क्या ख्याल है
yeah.
When I was younger, we used to have a bidet because I grew up in Italy. So I was always like, Ami, what is this? And she said, this is the Gora Lota.
Yeah.
I was like, that doesn't make any sense.
Gora Lota.
I thought it was a bath.
Yeah. Isn't it in Italy or other European countries, the bidet is like another toilet next to it. Like it's a
yes,
separate thing
exactly.
that you have to sit on.
It's right next to it. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I never understood how it worked. You like go to the toilet and then you get up and then you get on the bidet. Like,
Yeah, people have mistaken those for sinks. It's so gross.
Yes.
That's so nasty. You can't even imagine washing your face with that. But people have tried that. That's the thing. I mean, desi log khas taur pe bade, you know, clueless ho thinking. But
it's good for wudu though, because you can do your feet.
Really?
Arad yaar, khair jo bhi hai. Chalo, achha lote ka business to chal gaya. Kuch to Pakistan ko fayda ho.
Kuch. Back to our first conversation, I noticed a lot of people's sleep schedules have changed completely due to the lockdown. This became even more interesting with Ramzan. A lot of people who have strict morning schedules of school or work might possibly have a more relaxed Ramzan this year with more flexible hours. That's true for me, at least. I always find the topic of sleep schedules so interesting, and those of you who have listened to our Night Owls episode already know that about me. So here I asked a few of our guests to share what their sleep schedules were like before and after the lockdown.
So I used to be really regular on this and fall asleep at 11, and it's got worse and worse every week. only because I've had a lot of mood swings recently. Like mentally, I've had a lot of mood swings, and that really changes how much I'm on the internet. And I'm going back to like when I was 18 in school, and I'd be on like my phone till 4 a.m. So I found myself going to sleep a lot later recently, and like waking up at weird times in the night. And yeah,
mm-hmm. Yeah.
But I still always wake up at the same time in the morning, like 8 or 9.
8, yeah, yeah, yeah. Because you have to, right, for work.
Yeah,
that's the thing. Yeah, yeah. I sleep around 11, 12, and then yeah, I'll wake up like 6 or 7.
It's still decent, you know.
Yeah, yeah, exactly, right.
My sleep schedule wasn't good in the beginning either, and nor has it gotten any better with the quarantine. So
I don't know. I feel like getting older affects you as well, like late 20s. You do start feeling sleepier automatically. But I was always a night owl too growing up. Like when I was your age, Aman, I would stay up to like 3, whatever, and still get up by, you know, 6, 7 and go to work or go to school.
Yeah, yeah, same.
Yeah, that was basically what it was. It was sleeping at 4 or 5 a.m., waking up at 8 a.m. for university. Now it's sleeping at like 8 a.m. and waking up at 4 p.m. So it's completely gone out the window.
Yeah.
I have abandoned a sleep cycle. I'm just hoping that it just messes itself over enough that it just ends up fixing itself. That is literally what I'm banking on at this point.
You go the full circle on the clock, right? A full 24 hours, you'll keep messing up your...
It's a good experiment.
Yeah, but I got to go through so much daunt for that because I can't recall one day in the last week where I haven't woken up at like 4 p.m. and haven't had like my mom give you like a 10-minute lecture. Ke, jaage mein nahi hote, namaz to padhte nahi ho, isliye tumhe shayad corona bhi ho jaye. I'm like, what the heck?
Oh my gosh, I'm getting flashbacks.
Oh, Ramzan is going to be interesting.
Very interesting.
Yeah.
I know I'm not going to have to stress up about waking up for iftari and sehri anymore. I'll probably just be up anyways with my messed up cycle. So I'm the happiest I can be, man.
Mm-hmm. Good. Alhamdulillah.
Yeah. And for people who are working, it'll be a little bit easier, right? For people who are working and have to go to the office, right? And answer 1,000 questions because people are like, oh, why aren't you having lunch? I guess it'll make it a little bit easier for us.
I was just going to say that, yeah.
For the past 4 years, Ramzan was during my university summer. And the 4 years before that, it was during my high school summer. So basically, ever since I started fasting, I've just been sleeping at, like, right after Sehri and waking up at, like, 2 or 3 p.m. So my fast has always been really chill. This is going to be my first year actually working during Ramzan.
And fasting. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Meanwhile, in our Fazul dialogue, we somehow wandered into the topic of eating exotic or wild animals. And of course, my good friend from the Bay, Hassan, had a question to ask me.
Habib, you haven't eaten a mendak chimgadne.
Oh, yaar. The most exotic thing I've eaten is lobster.
It's completely halal. See, lobster and other halal.
Yeah, but I felt weird eating it. I don't know, because I didn't grow up eating lobster. I've had shrimp.
Yeah, same.
Do you guys eat sushi?
Yes. I tried sushi.
I like sushi.
I love sushi.
My mom eats it. My mom says, "Kachi machi, tusi loki khaa jande ho."
Same. My parents won't eat salmon because when I cook it, they're like, "Yaar, andar se pinka." I'm like, "Abu, it's supposed to be." So they want me to keep cooking it until it's brown.
Yeah, salmon is hard because of that. Salmon has this.
But it tastes so nice.
It tastes good, yeah. It has this weird smell too. A lot of people don't like that, but that's just how fish is. But I like fish.
Yeah, I ghost khoru yaar. Mujhe tum hafte mein 5 din ghost de do. Main wahi kha lunga. Main machhiyan kam hi khata hu.
Yeah. By ghost you mean like bakra and beef?
Bakre ki ta tum chaape bana lo ek din, agle din keema bana do, uske agle din nihari le aao, fir pae le aao.
Yeah.
Uske baad kuch aur kuch reh gaya hai?
Nahi.
Kuch reh gaya aur?
Agla virus tumse shuru hoga. कोई बो बकरा तुम्हें पड़ जाएगा उसमें से कोई बो बकरा वायरस निकलेगा हर बंदे को जप्पियां डालेगा
तुम तो आते नहीं हो मैंने तो तुम्हें कहा आ जाओ दुबई तुम आते नहीं हो जप्पी देने
नहीं यार तुम इंशाल्लाह अपनी शादी प्लान करो और फिर इंशाल्लाह जरूर आएंगे बैक विद अरफा अमान एंड हमजा वी स्पोक अबाउट हाउ कम्युनिटीज have responded to this COVID-19 outbreak. Each country, and even more specifically, each city and neighborhood seems to have reacted in different ways. Some great positive ways and some not so great. Where I live, for example, people seem to be very respectful of laws, including the requirement to wear a face mask in public and keeping distance. Yet in other parts of the US, people are protesting these regulations and demanding the government to open up and bring things back to normal. Here's Arfa talking about how her community in the London area has responded.
But one thing I do like is the community, the UK British community. That community feel is a lot stronger nowadays. I think they're doing it in US as well, where they do like the clap and stuff like that. Do they do that for the medical staff?
Yeah, yeah, right.
Yeah, they're doing like a clap for the NHS, yes, and rainbows and just that kind of stuff that we, I don't know about you guys, but here, like in the Muslim community, we have that a lot, that sense of community, that sense of ummah. But the Gori around here, like they're very independent, individualistic, so they don't really have that. And I think that's what's making a lot of people emotional, seeing all those like stories, those grassroots stories of people helping each other and coming together and delivering to doors. That's one thing I do really love about this situation.
It might be like that over there, but unfortunately in Pakistan, at least in Islamabad specifically, there hasn't been anything as such that's been going on over here. Over here is just kind of like, I guess the more environment is you're kind of on your own. So, you know, friends would tell each other, hey, stay indoors, yad, or people would just say around in the street, kid, don't come outside of the house too much. The police is doing a fantastic job here. What the police is doing is that they have set up barricades all around the city. So if you're out at an unusual hour, or, you know, they might stop you out randomly in the middle of the day and they'll check if you have a mask, if you have gloves, they'll check if you have sanitizers, they'll take your number plate down at times as well, if they're suspicious about you maybe, you know, passing a virus around or anything. So, you know, the police in that regard is doing great, but as for the community itself, Pakistani ki tendencies hi hai ki hum sirf politics ke mamle mein ikatte aate hain. We, unfortunately, for the virus, haven't really been doing anything as a community, other than maybe making the occasional Instagram post or Instagram story that, hey, don't step out of the house, you know, stay indoors, wash your hands, do this, blah, blah, blah. But as a community, we're not really doing too much either. It's just everybody's minding their own business. People are hesitant to talk to each other just because of the fact that they're afraid that, you know, oh, what if it transmits to me or whatever? What if that person's a carrier or not? So in that regard, Islamabad is just kind of, once you step out of the city, you might see a few people out, but you'll feel like it's a ghost town. Mainly for the reason that, you know, you don't see social interaction as much.
But I think that's good. Like, you know, that's good enough in itself.
In a way, yeah.
It's a completely different situation, obviously, because UK is like in a sense of privilege and luxury where we can afford to, you know, drive to a supermarket and deliver it to someone's door or order someone something. Mm-hmm. You know, it's a completely different thing. We're not really in that much a state of survival or with a massive population or anything. We do have a lot of like systems in place where you can just be like, hey, change everything to online. You know, we have a lot of resources and government support, so it's completely different. You know, even people staying at home, that's good.
Are people in your guys' area stepping out on their own for like early morning jogs and whatnot? Because there are a lot of people doing that here.
Yeah, so in UK we're allowed one exercise a day, and it's really ironic, I see more people in the street now than I did before. So people are going on like runs and then they see each other and they like kind of move away. It's so funny. Me and my sister went for a walk the other day and they said they came back laughing so much. I was like, yawa. And they were like, this is the first time in my life that a white man crossing the road was seen as a really nice gesture, not a racist thing. because he saw them and he just crossed the road and he was like smiling and like let them go past. And it was the funniest thing.
That's so funny though. I've never heard of that before. Like one exercise a day. I didn't know that was one of the restrictions in the UK.
Yeah, me neither.
Yeah.
Like, how do you even enforce that, right?
So how do you keep it? Yeah.
You exercise twice a day.
I saw you step out of your house twice.
Yeah. How dare you work out twice a day?
The memes are so funny. The memes are really funny that are coming out. There's like videos of people like sitting on the wall, like drinking something or on their phone. And then a police siren goes off and they quickly start star jumping or something.
I mean, yahan pe log, so a lot of gyms are closed, right? Including my gym. We have a gym downstairs in our apartment complex, part of the regulations. So people are going outside for jogs and stuff, which I don't think it's a bad thing. I think it's a good thing. The only thing that bothers me a little bit is that people are going to popular trails and parks and stuff like that.
Yes.
And you'll see like 100 people jogging there and pretty close to each other, you know, on the same trail. And that bothers me because it's one thing, like we go for walks, me and my wife, around our apartment complex. It's not that busy at all. And even here, if we do see somebody coming from the opposite side, they cross a road or we cross a road. So people are very respectful of each other's private space right now, personal space. But yeah, those types of areas, I don't think that's
definitely
good. The thing is that every 5:30 in the morning, I usually go out for an early morning jog, and the path I usually take is just within my own streets. You know, I don't really go to any popular spots. However, if you're driving around and you ever cross one of those popular spots, you'll notice that there are going to be like 200, 100 people easily just all doing their own thing. Like there's families out, there's people, like it's bringing people out, but I don't understand the purpose of why we're calling it social distancing when we're all going to popular spots where every single other human being is. Like, we don't realize that this completely, like us stepping out, sure, I get it, you want some fresh air, but going to a popular spot just completely defeats the purpose of your social distancing, you know, rant that you go on, that people go on.
That's so crazy. Yeah.
These popular spots, they're not necessarily like big areas either. Like parks and whatnot have been shut down. So people have resorted to going to hiking trails and, you know, going to very, very small popular roads where it's a big road, you know, people walk a lot over there. And you'll notice that, you know, there's just so many people, it just kind of defeats the purpose. You look around and you're like, this is no different than, you know, what it was like back when there wasn't a quarantine. So it's kind of disappointing to see that.
We've seen the results of people not taking this virus seriously. And the best example for that might be the US. Similarly, in a separate chat, we spoke a little bit about how other countries can take these learnings and apply them and avoid a similar fate. Unfortunately, it didn't seem like our guests had much confidence for a lot of the people back home who are not taking it seriously. Yeah, Pakistan, I just hope it doesn't spread like it did over here. But yeah, let's hope for the best.
Yeah, Pakistan, वहाँ पे अभी भी शादियां हो रही हैं खुलेआम चल रहे हैं लोग 400-500 बंदा शादी हॉल में जी सानू कुछ नहीं होना जी असी कोई नहीं मर जाने की है चलो जी नचो खाओ पियो
मरना तो है ही अल्लाह दी स्पुर्द
मरना तो आज भी
आज नहीं तो कल मर ही जाओगे बस नेक कम करके मरिए
खुशियां मना लियो यार फिर कोई
ये पहली बार हो रहा है ना यार यही तो मसला है कि दुनिया में पहली बार ऐसा कुछ हुआ है लाइक दिस इज क्रेजी इट टर्नड एवरीथिंग अपसाइड डाउन
ऐसी बात नहीं है यार प्लेग्स आए हैं पास्ट में
ना मगर ये पहली बार मॉडर्न लाइक इन मॉडर्न टाइम्स
या बेसिकली यू नो द प्रॉब्लम इज लोग 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 आई रिमेंबर समबडी सेड के यार पहले भी तो जैसे ब्लैक प्लेग या इसके सब की जब चीज आई थी
ओह या
तो देयर वाज लाइक सबसे पहली बात तो ये है कि ब्लैक द ब्लैक प्लेग जो थी वो शुरू हुई थी यूरोप में और फिर ये सारे गोरे हमारे मुस्लिम लैंड्स की तरफ लेकर आ गए थे और फिर वहां पे बट इट टुक सम टाइम क्योंकि दैट ऑल हैपेंड ड्यूरिंग द क्रूसेड्स सो इट टुक प्रोबब्ली अबाउट 100-150 इयर्स एंड देन इट स्टेड for a good period of time. Lekin yahan pe obviously we live in a global village. People fly all over the place.
Yeah. It's a weird time for a lot of us. Unprecedented in the sense that many companies and governments and schools are asking us to just sit at home. For extroverts, this is obviously very, very hard, as Aman will tell us in a little bit. For introverts like myself, it might seem to you that it's very easy for us, but it's not always the case. At the end of the day, human beings are social animals, and we have just discovered that cabin fever is a real thing.
I'm a really grateful person. Like, every day I write something I'm grateful for. The one thing I've never thought of is the fact that my family are hermits. Like, we have gone days where we haven't unlocked the front door. Like, we didn't go outside.
Wow.
We've had days like that, and I hated it because I like going out. I like going out every day, and I had like 3 years at uni. I graduated, I came home, and the adjustment is so different. Like, I never go out, and I'm like a Pakistani girl at home. Like, where am I going to go? I finished uni. Like, where do you need to go? I didn't have a job. There's no reason for me to like go to the shop. Dad will do that. So I had to stay inside anyway. And I was never think to be grateful for the fact that my family are so good at being at home until this happened. I was like, oh, well, you know what? We're kind of used to this. In a sad kind of way, I was like grateful for it.
Challenge accepted.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm probably the only one who's suffering the most out of my family because of this, because my dad, obviously, after working, when he comes back home, the first thing he does is just knocks out. So he's home whenever he wants to be home for every second he gets. My brother and sister, they don't step out nearly as much as I do either, so they're at home as well. My mom to mere piche kitni rehti hai ghar pe baitho. So when I look at the rest of my family, wo around the terrace pe baith ke chai pee rahe hote, chill maar rahe hote, ras kha rahe hote, like as if it, like nothing's wrong. And here I am downstairs banging my head against the wall that I need to get out of this house. So funny. Here's the funny thing. I always thought to myself that, you know, no matter what happens, you know, I'm always gonna love this extroverted side of me. You know, I'm always gonna love stepping out of the house. I'm always gonna love meeting people. But right now, I promise you, I haven't regretted stuff. I regret like the habit I built that I used to step out so much. Because all my introverted friends, they're like, "What are you complaining about? Just enjoy it. You know, learn to enjoy some peace and quiet." I'm like, "No, I can't."
Yeah, no, it does definitely bring perspective.
Due to the free time that we have on our hands, thanks to the isolation, I asked our guests how they're passing their time. Many of us, you and me, probably have so much free time that we're watching more movies and TV shows than usual, or at least I am. However, some of us have found ways to be more productive than usual, or pick up a new hobby. My wife Shireen, for example, she spent this time practicing things that normally she would have to pay for, like doing her nails, cutting her own bangs, giving me a haircut, learning to cook new types of dishes. And she's even made Ramzan and Eid decorations herself. And of course, we've been watching a lot of movies and TV shows. Some of the shows that we picked up are Money Heist, The Kingdom, Hannibal, Sopranos, and a few others. Here's what our guests had to say, starting with Hamza.
So I've been going through a early 2000s Bollywood binge. So I've watched like Kal Ho Na Ho, Kabhi Khushi Kabhi Gham, Kabhi Alvida Na Kehna, and a couple others over the past couple weeks.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Other than that, I've been watching this Japanese/British show called Giri Haji. It's on Netflix. It's got really good ratings, and I would recommend it.
Could you spell that?
Yeah. G-I-R-I and then H-A-J-I.
Oh, okay.
It's called Duty and Shame if you convert it to English. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
And it's good? Okay. I'll check it out.
Yeah.
I'm so boring, Yaj. I haven't really watched films in Netflix. I was watching this documentary called Icarus on Netflix, though. I think it's got really high ratings, so it's pretty good. I like documentaries. I'm a human geographer, so I find everything about this really fascinating. So I'm enjoying watching the people around me and like kind of psychoanalyzing. And but other than that, I just like cooking and like making use of the fact that outside is so quiet right now. I go into my garden. I mean, alhamdulillah, I have a garden and I go into the garden and it's like sunny now. So I just kind of relax.
Well, that's good. That's interesting because you're passing your time a little differently than most people are, because most people are just watching movies and playing games and that type of stuff. So it's good you're doing other things to keep yourself busy.
I never got into gaming and I never used my laptop ever apart from uni. And yeah, I'm just really bad at like being online, even though I'm a homebody, like I stay at home a lot. I don't know what, I just do a lot of nothing. Like, I don't know what, I actually don't know what I do. I just do a lot of nothing. But yeah.
I'm probably the last person you should ever ask about Netflix shows or movie series and whatnot, because since I've probably watched 2 shows my entire life, but I am watching Money Heist. And like you read, I'm still on the first season. I haven't gone past that yet either. So obviously, Money Heist, I'm pretty sure everybody's basically been watching that. But other than that, I don't really watch too many movies or shows to begin with. Most of my time's either used up, either on call with friends, either that, or, you know, I'm usually out doing ghar ke kaam, I'm just playing video games. There is one thing that I have been doing, which I wasn't doing before the quarantine, which was learning to cook.
Yes.
I finally got some time to stay at home and I was like, you know what? I have the entire kitchen to myself. I'm going to start learning to cook. I am a terrible chef, but I'm getting better.
Yay, that makes me so happy.
That's good.
Maybe just picking up like, you know, a random skill would be just a good way to pass time as well. You could learn literally something that you've been thinking about doing that you haven't gotten the time to do. And now you're at home all the time. So you might as well just
Come out better. Yeah.
I've been using Discord more for like finding international people. I love learning languages. So I keep trying to find people from the languages I'm trying to learn and like getting them onto VC, and I'm like, speak to me, and teach me more. Oh, yeah, cool. It's going really well. It's like really fun. Like people are so much more online and available to just be like, yeah, sure.
What languages are you trying to learn?
So obviously I know English and Urdu fluently. I grew up in Italy, so I kind of like learned a lot of Italian, but it's really faded. So I found a lot of Italians to kind of like talk to. Arab, like every Muslim claims that they know a little bit of Arabic, but you know, we can say Surafanta or something. But I did a few classes and I found some like Arabs and like all just people from UAE in general. And they all tell me a different dialect, which is really confusing. But yeah, it's been really fun. There's no point going into this. I learned like, I dabble in like 8 other languages just because of the people I've met.
Wow.
Yeah, where I went to uni, it was so diverse. I lived with a Polish, a Latvian, a Lithuanian, and a Filipino spoke English. But I learned all their languages. Not in depth, obviously, just like stupid things like I love potato and hi, phrases. Hello, good morning.
That's good though. That's good.
Yeah.
Good enough, yeah.
And the like corner shop was like, there were, I think they were Turkish at the corner shop, and I never knew what language they were speaking. So I just asked, and then I would go on YouTube before I went into the store, and I would like see on YouTube how to say hello, like 50 times, and go in and just be like, hello. And they'd get so happy. You make so much connection by just speaking someone's language. So I really like that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah,
definitely.
A for effort.
Thanks. Well, I'm not doing anything else.
No, but that's still a productive way to use your time. You know, it's better than just sitting there idly and not doing anything at all. At least you're like, you know, learning like new languages and whatnot, which is productive.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely learning shit. Yeah, yeah.
Learning shit.
I like that.
Yeah. That's it for this episode's Guftagu. So how are you getting by during this pandemic? Do you have any stories to share yourself? Email us at hello@pakkur.com or DM us on Instagram, and I'd love to hear your stories and possibly even share them with our audience, with your approval, of course. If you would like to join our Discord server, visit pakkur.com/discord. You can find the link in the episode description as well. We'll see you next time. Take care and stay healthy.